out to Jonathan Taylor. Huge hole. He's at the 30. He's going to go. 10, 5, touchdown. Jonathan Taylor made a man miss the line of scrimmage and then runs it into Pater. A one-handed INT. Are you kidding me? Kenny Moore.
What a play by Nyheim Hines.
Horseshoe is back, baby. The horseshoe is back.
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to another episode of the Bring the Juice Colts podcast. So basically today we're going to start with kicking off a series that we kind of did last year. And this time we're going to break down the each position group room and kind of break it down into a little more detail. Kind of what we think is going to happen, kind of break down the players. You know, things like that. I want to try to get Lawrence Owen onto this because I like his film analysis and I trust his opinion on this stuff. I couldn't get him tonight for this one, but I will be sure to try and get him involved in more groups going forward. I feel like this one's probably the easiest for me to explain. So, you know, we'll get a more hands-on approach, a different perspective from Lawrence here in future videos for sure. But nevertheless, we'll kind of break down the three players who we assume are going to be part of this quarterback room going forward. And I guess we might as well start with the third string quarterback, and that is going to be Sam Ehlinger. Now, obviously, we don't know that. We'll have to see what happens come training camp, but, you know, just kind of what we're expecting, right? So Sam Ehlinger provides a very unique style of gameplay that I think helps the Colts defense in a lot more ways than what Jacob Eason does. Okay. And here's why I explain that. And I'll say it again, because I've said this multiple times in videos and everything else, that the reason that Sam Ehlinger is such an intriguing prospect is because he has the mobility and the ability to move on the run and create plays with his feet the way that Jacob Eason really just doesn't, okay? Now, I'm not saying Jacob Eason can't move around. He's shown that he has the ability to throw on the run, but that's usually not his forte. But Sam Ehlinger is a much different quarterback. He's a much more smaller but yet more nimble quarterback. Somebody that for defenses like the Colts are very helpful for scout teams when they're trying to prepare for another team's offense. You know, a couple teams that we're going to have to face this year are going to have some mobile quarterbacks. Obviously, Lamar Jackson comes to mind. If you're going to play Cleveland in the playoffs, you got to deal with Baker Mayfield. If you're going to play the Chiefs in the playoffs, you got to face Patrick Mahomes. If we're going to face the Bills and Josh Allen, that we know can run. You know, there's a lot of different quarterbacks in this conference that the Colts really will have to focus on. And Russell Wilson, week one, Russell Wilson has the ability to move, has the ability to run. You know, it's one of those aspects where it isn't something that helps on the field necessarily, but it helps with the preparation, which eventually leads to the product on the field. So it's very important that you draft a guy like that and you set a character discern in that locker room. And you know the Colts, they're always about competition, so you never know. Sam Ehlinger could make that spot at some point. All right, let's go into Jacob Eason here. Jacob Eason, there's a lot less to really wonder about considering, you know, we've seen this guy for an offseason. We now know that the Colts have said he's still another year away from being where they expect him to be. But, however, the OCs and all the other coaches, the quarterback coaches, they're all saying how happy they are with his progress. And the way he's going through his progressions is very, very good. Now, granted, we have not seen Jacob Eason play a meaningful snap yet, and including meaningful, it even means the preseason. We have yet to see him go into a preseason game. The NFL did not have preseason games last year. So that kind of put Jacob Eason back even more. So you're in a situation now where you might be able to do that now. You finally get a chance to kind of see what Jacob Eason brings to the table. How well are the progressions going through? How much of an arm does he have truly? Is it getting more accurate? Is he reading progressions? Is he going through his steps? Is he not just going through the motions, but actually taking the step? Right. So, you know, again, just another question on whether or not we'll see. And, you know, it'll be exciting to see Jacob Eason really explode in off season and in preseason to kind of see a little more and understand where he is as a player. All right, let's talk about the new Indianapolis Colts quarterback in Carson Wentz. So we talk about some of the numbers here. We might as well just talk about it. So, all right, 6'5", 235 pounds, so a big guy. We obviously know this. And surprisingly enough, completion percentage-wise, you know, it's not been great for some of the years. In 2017, he was really good, even though that was one of his lowest completion percentage years, which is quite crazy to think about. But we also recognize that, you know, the Eagles ran the ball a lot more often in that system and in the fact that their wide receivers were absolute crap. I bear to argue that their wide receiver core was just as bad as ours at dropping the football. But in 2018 and 2019, when, you know, he really had his best statistical years outside of the touchdowns to interceptions. I mean, even in 2018, 21 touchdowns to 7 interceptions, and he only played in 11 games that year, so he didn't play the full schedule. My guess, he probably would have ended up having close to 30 touchdowns that year if he had played all of them. 2019 had 27 touchdowns, 7 interceptions. And 2017, when the Eagles went on to, you know, compete for a Super Bowl and everything else, he threw 33 touchdowns and 7 interceptions. So he did a really good job there. And also, when you look at the rushing yards that this guy's been able to add up, over 5 years in Philly, has over 1,000 yards rushing and has 8 rushing touchdowns. Had 5 of them this last year. So he's shown the ability to go on the run and make a play with his feet if he has to, right? That's not his first instinct, but it is something that he can do. So we've been saying it again so many times over the offseason that the reason this offense now looks a lot more interesting is because of the, in defensive terms, the instability of what you can predict with Carson Wentz. You know, with Phillip Rivers, you knew Phillip Rivers was never going to run. You always knew it was either going to be the running backs running the football, or it was going to be, most of the time, could keep him in a pocket. But now, with Carson Wentz, who has shown a lot of the ability to escape the pocket and escape it very well, even when pressured, and be able to make those big plays and those dramatic highlight plays and be able to run on his own and be able to run options, to run RPOs, to run other things, it gives Frank Reich so much more flexibility with that offense and being able to basically give the Colts an advantage up, because you now have a lot more uncertainty for your defenses that you're facing, which is obviously a great thing. But the ultimate question is, is Carson Wentz actually going to be able to put all of this together? And I think the majority of Colts fans have said that yes, given the right circumstance, which I think he's in now, with the right head coach, which I think he has now, in a good position where he's got a great offensive line, has a great running back room, has decent young wide receivers who show a lot of potential and speed, and a defense that can actually get off the field more times than what the Eagles did last year, then I think now you're in a position where you feel a lot more comfortable and are going to get more opportunities. So let me know what you guys think about this quarterback room. It's kind of the first step into it. But nevertheless, thank you guys so much for tuning in. Really appreciate all of you. Thank you so much. And as always, go Colts.